Hydrogenated oils and my fibromyalgia symptoms.
Grandma's porch. Sit down, relax, enjoy. Here on Grandma's porch.
Hydrogenated oils and fibromyalgia symptoms. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brienne. Well, first of all, I'm not a medical specialist. And second of all, I don't give advice or suggestions. I just share with you my life journey and how I see different issues. My name is Diana Brienne. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all five of my channels. Links are pinned to the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me, I will likely connect back with you with all five channels. So I wanted to come on here today and talk about hydrogenated oils and how they affect my body. Everyone is different, and so everyone is going to be affected differently. Some people may not be affected at all. You know, when I was younger and I could pretty much eat anything, including hydrogenated oils, and it wouldn't affect me at all, or at least it didn't seem like it. I never noticed it. But as I grew older, one of the things that I noticed that anytime I had anything that was like margarine, hydrogenated oils, anything that was not a natural cooking oil or a natural food oil, like, you know, like olive oil, coconut oil, walnut oil, grapeseed oil, anything that wasn't like that, my body would react to it. Now, I don't have fibromyalgia, and I'm not exactly even sure what fibromyalgia is, but from my understanding, it can be a very uncomfortable feeling. So I will tell you what symptoms I get when I have hydrogenated oil in my diet. Whenever I've eaten something with hydrogenated oil, usually at night when I go to bed, I have this terrible muscle deep inside, kind of muscle achy type of uncomfortable feeling. And what reminded me of all this was yesterday I made some fried pickles. Y'all know I love fried pickles, fried green tomatoes and all of that. But normally I use olive oil, coconut oil, grapeseed oil, walnut oil, things like that. If I'm going to use any kind of oils, I'm not a big advocate of using a lot of oil. And so I didn't have any olive oil. So I decided to use some hydrogenated oil that I kept on hand. And I did. Well, I have to tell you, when I went to bed last night, I ached so bad that I had to take a Tylenol, which I normally do not take. And so the thing about it is this, is that I've discovered for my own body type, hydrogenated oils of any kind, whether I get it in the fast food, whether I get it in a product, whether I add it to my cooking, it affects my body. And I do think foods do affect our bodies. I can't say for sure, but I do believe that different kinds of food will affect our body. Healthy foods will affect our body likely in a healthy way. Unhealthy foods such as hydrogenated oils will likely affect our body in an unhealthy way. So for me, that's my experience with hydrogenated oil. I don't use it. I don't like it. For me, I use it on other things to shine up stuff, but I do not use it inside my body as I did yesterday by kind of because I didn't have any olive oil on hand, but today I'm going out to get my olive oil. And so I come on here and I share with you different topics. And like I said, I don't give advice, suggestions, or information. I just share with you my journey, okay? From my house to yours, may God bless you. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all five of my channels. Links are pinned to the top of the comment section below. And if you connect with me with all five channels, I will likely connect back with you with all five channels. Hope to talk to you soon again. Bye-bye.
relax and a place to enjoy. Grandma's Porch.